Ryan Whitfield. Brian Whitfield from Atlanta, Georgia. Started playing basketball around 16. I noticed I could be good around my junior year. And then from there, I just kept grinding, getting better and better to get in the position I'm in right now. Biggest part of my motivation will have to be when I was in 10th grade, everybody was like, oh, he's not good, he'll never make it. That just motivated me to prove everybody wrong. And now I'm in the position I'm in right now. Now everybody want to be cool with me. But that ain't me, man. I go hard in this game because one day I want to be able to provide for my family and just give back to everybody who was down for me. Like, just help me out no matter, like, what it was. Like, when I ain't have nothing, like my boy E, you know what I'm saying, gave me flights to go to schools and stuff like that. So I've been preparing for this upcoming season. I've been working out with my guy, Keen, NBA trainer, working out with now. Just getting right every day. So when it's time for the season to run around, which is right here, it's gonna get scary.
Try to live life lavish. She ain't fucking with no average. I'm in love with the top. I done ran through the guap when I walk in baggy. Chop this little picture like magic. On the go, gotta have it. Fuck your hoe like a savage. Fuck your hoe like a savage. All that ice, all the carrots. That's your hoe, like she worried. Look down at my phone, it's 3 a.m. And all these missed calls came from you. Something about this cat that made me fall through. Look down at my phone, it's 3 a.m. and all these missed calls came from you. You. I've been up 3 days, it's something about this cat that made me. Now I gotta have it. But I can't talk to a savage. No one more time, baby, check out the fashion. Fuck, I might take the bank straight to the casket. Pulling up, send me the 80. Throw up this cash, watch it fall to the floor. Put down in the H, run a candy. Pour up a cup, rest in peace, the big mo. Gotta watch my back, I'm not just anybody. No, 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 I'm not average. Fuck it, hold up,
yeah, but no joke.
Something about this case that made me.
What it is, tell me what do you feel?
When I get in your face, ain't no time to my miss calls ring no long. Sure to be talking for you, we ballin'. I bring the bed and fuck to the morning. Give you some head, you running in morning. Hold out the money, you want it, I'm on it. Tribulations, murder right at the corner. I tend for to throw you so much you can't handle. Account at the bottom, it ran off. Police gave me a case with my hand up. I'ma live like a dog, stand up. Headed to where you be at. I'ma fall and jump in and I, yeah. I approach and I get in your head. Bringing up shit that somebody done said.
All that ice, all the carrots. That's your hoe,
why she worried.
Look down at my phone, it's 3 a.m. and all these missed calls came from you. You. I've been up 3 days, it's something about this cat that made me fall through. Look down at my phone, it's 3 a.m. and all these missed calls came from you.
225, squat, 3 sets of 12, leg incline, leg press, 3 sets of 12, everything was 225, that joke was crazy.
They be killing y'all out there, I don't even understand it.
On me, bro. They be tearing me up, bro, I ain't gonna count.
For real, for real.
Hey, no. Nah, you probably was up 5.
Oh, no, I was up, I was working
five,
on, yeah. Yeah,
I'm
facts.
I say, you be up.
I was working on Gordon stuff.
That man be up at 5. Oh, Gordon's up?
Yeah, they had some promo stuff. Get ready for their season.
I know that's gonna be tough.
Shoot, it's already done.
Who, Gordon's up?
Mm-hmm. Because they're gonna have they gotta meet the team on
Monday?
On Wednesday.
Seriously, I remember like yesterday, I was looking back on my phone and I saw some footage like May 25th when we was in the gym working out. Conditioning wasn't so good also then, but you continue to work. I seen a lot of improvement. One good thing you've learned is to take criticism. I think in a game of basketball, you're always going to be criticized. You always have to prove a point. But you have to be able to take criticism in order to improve. For yourself, one day we get into it. I'm giving you criticism on your game. I'm challenging you. The next day, you come back ready to work. I think that shows great improvement, a big leap, jump in your game. We made uncanny changes to your jump shot. It's more smoother now. You're hitting it on a more consistent basis. And I think you as a player, one thing you got that a lot of kids and a lot of players don't have is you work hard on your own. We walk in the gym 8, 7 in the morning. You already in here working out. Or even sometimes we get in before you. You walk in the door later. And a lot of people just don't have that. So you have to continue to grow with that. You have to continue to keep that passion because becoming a pro, becoming the best player you can be, it's bumps, it's bruises, but it's a grind, it's a journey. It doesn't come tomorrow. It just doesn't happen that way. So you just have to keep grinding, keep with a good mentality, good attitude, and believe in yourself most importantly. But like I said, be able to take criticism because people are gonna always critique your game, but they're not gonna critique it all the time in a bad way. Some people actually there to benefit you, help you. So you have to be able to take that kind of info and just keep working. Spin it to something positive all the time. You know what your goals are, your dreams are. You can't let no one perturb you from that. So got to put your head down and start grinding. Like me, I've been doing the NBA training for now, 11, 12 years, on numerous NBA players throughout this gym. Then I met you and started working with you. So just by your take, your approach to the game, I know what your avenues, I know what your drive is, I know what your dreams are. So you have to continue to work, man. That's all.
Shoot, this is really the meeting grounds right here. First time I saw B, was in here playing open gym. I came back from Gordon, in here running it. I'm just being honest, in here running it. That's back when I could still shoot from half court. So I'm coming down pulling from half court. So he get on the court one game. I'm talking about we running the gym. He get on the court one game, and he going at it. You know, we still got the dub, but we got into it while we was playing. That's the first. I was like, who is this? And everybody was like, that's Brian. I'm like, Brian who? And he left. But that was the first time I met him. And after that, you know, he used to come up here early in the morning with Kent and Jones. Come up here, work out. Kent Jones would talk to us just about life, a lot of stuff. I'm talking about 6 a.m. every morning. And then we'll leave, go eat, come back. Leave, go eat, come back. And then started hooping. So we would just hoop everywhere, all rec centers, anywhere. It didn't even matter where. And at that time, I was still working with kids and stuff like that. And then he ended up being the first like college athlete to trust me with his game. And then just started working out, going crazy. I just tried to show him a lot of the stuff that I used, a lot of the things that helped me get better quicker, and just help him develop his game. And here we are today. You know, a couple years later, he still has that same grind, still goes crazy. Like, so it's gonna be a good year right here. Just going into this semester right here, you know, he's gonna be in a great situation, game-wise. He's been taking care of his work off the court, just homework and things of that nature, schoolwork. So going into this semester right here, you know, it's only up after that. So we're gonna see what he do. And then after that, I'm gonna adjust. Feel me? About to get this work in. He used to come out here, we go in the gym, hoop, work out, come out here in the grass, get on the hill, get in the sand dunes. That's over with for today though, I ain't gonna lie. I ain't feeling that. My leg's dead, his leg's dead. Let me get out here, get this work in.
$55 plus tax. That ain't some money you post. You lying in all of your cash.
Let me find out. That ain't your car, bitch, that's a rental. That ain't your bitch, you in the friend zone. That ain't Kylie, bitch, that's Kendall. Let me find out. Those ain't diamonds, bitch, them QZ. Spend your real up on some Gucci. Ooh, got a gun, but you ain't shooting.
Listen, ooh, let me find out. Snitching on your dog for freedom. Don't throw no money when the weed come. You got a family, but don't feed them. Let me find out.
Heard you wanna be like me, but you don't got what it takes. Heard you don't even own no car, but you just post a rave, yeah. If you ain't capping nowadays and you can't fit in, it's two-seater, got 220 on the dash and you can't get in. My dog just came home, gave him a bone on his feet. Now I swear I'm living better, I ain't got a sibling for me to sleep. Now my mixtapes on repeat, now I ain't gotta be in the streets. Now I'm still keeping my feet, now hope a nigga don't think it's sweet, huh? Heard you posting what you don't buy.
That's
all
I just
went and bought my six watch. Ain't Kevin, I'm on my 10 cards. Heard through the grapevine, that money ain't jars.
Let me find out.
Who niggas are back running? Whatever it is. Pasta. It's too weak to call it pasta. It's too weak to call it pasta. But it's strong enough to be called back.
Let me find out.
She didn't really try to, like, sauce it up. She cooked it.
Ooh, let me find out. Snitching on you.